think there's not a direct discrepancy between my impressions of him as a person and an artist, but they are sort of different points on a line, where as a person, I definitely perceived of him as very discreet, bordering on shy. All that, he was extremely eloquent, I mean, in many languages, but also in the sense of expressing his feelings when he wanted to, extremely precise, words always very well chosen. As an artist, he was much more direct, very demanding, again, extremely polite and you know, great words to work with, but very to the point, very aware where he wanted to go. So all that you could mistake him for being soft, I think he was also quite, not hard, but demanding, I'd say, and very, had a very clear vision of where he wanted to go. I think working with Johann has meant actually a lot for me personally, because it has given me courage in ways that were unexpected, because he didn't come from a sort of proper composer corner of the world, and yet he was doing really big scores and really big assignments. I think what draws me and a lot of other people to Johann's music offhand, and this is just my personal idea about it, is that in somehow or in some ways it draws on a common heritage. I wouldn't say it was hymn-like, but it has something of that sort of pan-European simplicity, which isn't pop music, and it isn't church music, and it isn't, you know, things you would want to label it with to make it easy to understand. I just think somehow it draws on some kind of Western European melodic material that we feel at home with. They are usually sort of short thematic entities that he develops and then uses them over and over. So it's also, you feel that sense of recognition very fast, as if you've heard it before. It's definitely his, but he draws on a common heritage that we feel safe with. I think it resonates really well with a lot of people. Even though I have many favorite pieces of Johann's, but I think the one that I return to is actually Ode ad Amo, which is maybe not very original. And what caught my attention immediately was this phony, electronically generated countertenor wannabe sound, which I just thought was intriguing. I couldn't believe it.